My name is Jadie Barringer, Jr., and I want to welcome you to Pineapple Playhouse, premiere of the Juneteenth Experience. Now, I want to let you know something. Juneteenth Experience is, why is Juneteenth a federal holiday? What does it mean? Every culture has a past. This past has to do with the African American culture. And hopefully, it'll be entertaining, motivating, and educating.
Go with the dogs.
The people that are acting tonight or today are people from the community like you and me. Only one really has a past of acting. The others, it's their first time. What you just did there is what they really love. It encourages the actors. They want to do, they want to please you. And that's what we're looking for. Now, like I said, 99% of the actors are inexperienced. They never act before. But if by chance you do see an actor that just captivates you, I will become their manager. So come to me and we can talk. Okay. I can't thank you so much for coming out. It means so much to me and to the cast. I'd just like to acknowledge that the thought that I've gotten from the Pineapple Playhouse. If you read your playbill, you will see my segments to Pineapple Playhouse. That they are not just in this community, they're part of this community. Last night's production was sold out. And today, we're going to be sold out. So, without further ado, I hope the experience that you have today, the Juneteenth experience, will be captivating, memorable, and I think fruitful discussion. Okay? Enjoy yourselves. Thank you once again for coming.
Thank you.
Right.
We got to pass this around.
Let's check it around.
$150 right there. That's enough fire in your fireplace to keep you warm for 2 years. Leave you for the number of Christmases if you economize right around. Leave you me, it's a very big reward. Very handsome reward. You there. Pass them out. Keep it going. Pass that info.
See anything over there?
No, sir.
No, sir.
You keep on passing out that info. That means your life and his.
He must have went this way. We gotta get going. Let's go.
Come on, Jeb. Pick those feet up. Let's go. Let's go.
Come on. Let's go.
Good job. You find that kid? You got it. Come on, girl.
In late August 1619, a ship arrived in the British colony of Virginia, bearing a cargo of 20 to 30 enslaved people from Africa. Their arrival led to the barbaric and unprecedented system of American chattel slavery that would last for the next 250 years. Slaves were punished for not working fast enough, for being late getting to the fields, for defying authority, for running away, and for a number of other reasons. The punishments took many forms, including whippings, torture, mutilation, imprisonment, and being sold away from the plantation. Imagine the pain and blood that was spilled over the 250 years as we watch this system unfold, starting from the time they got off the ship.
$50. Can we bring it up to $75? $75. $75. 75, all right. Now, gentlemen, take a look at these Negroes. Let your minds run wild, huh? Walk around, walk around. Let me take a good look at you. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Come on, girl. Yeah. Come on up. Yeah. Well, before you get up there, take a little spin around, girl. Yeah, now as you can see, yeah, she is of the childbearing age, with some childbearing hips. These shots upon her, son. All right, you get up on here now. Careful there. All right. Now let's see if we can get the bidding started at $200. $200, right there, $200. $200, $225. There you are, $225. Give me go to $250. $250,
$250.
I'll do $250. There you are, yeah, you win $250. All right, give me go $275.
Hey, you, that's mine, and she's $375.
Woo! $375. Oh, girl, you hear that? $375. Okay, well, $375, go once. $375, go twice. Woo! Sold to Virginia for $375. Oh, girl. Oh, what is your name?
Imani.
Imani. Well, that is pretty. Imani. Woo! All right, well, Imani, your name from here on out, Imani, your name's now gonna be Hetty. Yeah, I think that's pretty. All right, there you go, Hetty.
Study war no more.
down my burden
down by the riverside.
I taught them all how to do that. How to spell, how to sing. And they keep such wonderful rhythm. Well, they do. Much better than the boys I used to sing with. You know, I grew up in a very musical family. Paris, and he played the same songs just like they sang in the cabin right over there. It was wondrous, tempestuous. I wish I could hire someone like him to keep them in line, honestly.
Thank you. here tells me that you've been a little late with the required amount of cotton being picked.
No, 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 sir. I got some cuts and bruises on my hand, and I was taking the election times to rattle around. So I'm thinking taking the election times to pick, but I just didn't want to get the cotton dirty with my gloves, you see.
Luke, I think that Ben needs to learn that it ain't about how he feels. It's about how I feel. Teach him a lesson.
No, 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 Master. Please don't beat me, no. I'm sorry. I'll stay and say goodnight, man. I'll stay after dark. Stay in fields and pick.
How are you going to pick when it's dark?
Well, you see, the moon. The moon is a big, bright, beautiful, and the cotton. It's white. So that's about all I need to pick. Now, later.
Okay, boy, I'll give it one more chance. Whip him anyway. He needs to be an example so nobody else tries.
Come on.
Let's go, man. Yeah. Stay back. You guys get lashes, too. Let's go. Let's go. Go on there.
Thousands of slaves sought freedom. Thousands more would have if they knew they were slaves.
Then I tell Isaac,
you hear anything, you come back and tell me. But then I go outside. I walk around amongst them, and I tell the big bucks, it seems to me that Isaac is getting a little uppity. Laughing at them, making jokes about them, going on about how much better he is than them. And I tell them, I don't think that's right. And I tell them, I would appreciate if they would keep an eye on Isaac, let me know if he's planning anything. Now, I gotta watch each other, and I don't gotta watch nobody.
Troubles of the world. son?
Son? Just really, you should go and see this now. Keep the wound on your left side of your head. Josiah, remember, you're strong. You come from kings and queens and warriors. And there ain't nothing you can't do. I love you, son.
I love you, I was told to come here, that I'd be safe here.
Who told you that?
My father.
It's all right. What's your name, sir?
Josiah, sir.
Josiah? Yes, sir. Where are you coming from and where are you going?
I'm coming from the Colonel's plantation. I'm trying to make it north to freedom.
And then three men knocking on my door this time of night with dogs suspicious. And who might you all be?
Well, apparently, Pastor, you didn't notice. I'm an officer of the law. I've been duly sworn in to do my duties. It says here on this paper somewhere, I don't think you have it. In there somewhere, I don't know where it's at. That I have the right to hunt down any slave. Turning them back to their owners as I see fit. Now, we're escaping an escapee boy, hunting an escapee boy from the Colonel's plantation. We've been hunting all day long. So,
welcome.
You, Isaac. You got the door. At least you speak more eloquently than Jed.
You. Why do I only have one plate on the table? Don't both you eat together?
Well, you see, that's for me. She's already eaten, my wife. You see, I'll have to come home late.
Sometimes, you know what I do. Unfortunately, you don't always have a chance to eat together.
Why are you out so late for?
Hold on, just a little while longer. Hold on, just a little while longer. Hold on, just a little while longer. Everything will be all right. Got to hold on just a little while longer. Hold on just a little while longer. Hold on just a little while longer. Everything will be all right. You got to pray on just a little while longer. Pray on just a little while longer. Pray on just a little while longer. Everything will be alright. You've got to fight on just a little while longer. Fight on just a little while longer. Fight on just a little while longer. Everything will be alright. Everything will be alright. Everything will be yours.
but also is there.
Has the black man not proven that he is a man? He can hold a gun like any other. He can hold a knife. He can march and counter-march like any other.
I would. But I just don't know if Delaware, Maryland, Kentucky, Missouri, and West Virginia would abide.
You know, give the black man a fighting chance. Give us a badge that is Negro. Give us a badge that says West. A brass buckle that says Negro. Give us a musket on our shoulders, bullets in our pocket. There is no power on this earth that can say that we have not earned the right of citizenship.
After 1863, there were over 180,000 troops, 175 regiments, involved in every major battle of the Civil War. They served with distinction, honor, and bravery amid racial discrimination and adverse circumstances, including the risk of enslavement and torture if captured. Norwood P. Halliwell, Colonel 55th Regiment, Massachusetts Volunteers, may have said it best. Let us never forget the debt we owe to the colored soldiers. Let us always be willing to give them whatever credit is their due. We called upon them in the day of our trial, when volunteering had ceased, when the draft was a partial failure, and the bounty system a senseless extravagance. They were ineligible for promotion. They were not to be treated as prisoners of war. Nothing was definite except that they could be shot and hanged as soldiers. Fortunate indeed is it for us, as well as for them, that they were equal to the crisis, that the grand historic moment which comes to a race only once in many centuries came to them, and that they recognized it. They saw that the day of their redemption had arrived. They escaped through the rebel lines of the South. They came from all over the North. And when the war closed, the names of 186,000 men of African descent were on the rolls. 18 members of the USCT were awarded the Medal of Honor, the highest honor in the United States for bravery in combat. December 31st, 1862, slaves waited in churches for the dawning of the promised emancipation, called Watch Night. Still today, services held on New Year's Eve in many black churches are called Watch Night services. January 1st, 1863, the Emancipation Proclamation becomes effective. April 9, 1865, General Robert E. Lee surrendered his Confederate troops to the Union's Ulysses S. Grant at Appomattox Courthouse. The Civil War is over. The 13th Amendment to the United States Constitution, ratified in 1865, abolished slavery in every state and territory of the United States. Juneteenth, or June 19th, marks the day in 1865 that Union Army Major General Gordon Granger issued General Order No. 3 in Galveston, which announced the freedom of more than 250,000 enslaved black people in the state of Texas.
Mm.
by the President of the United States of America, a proclamation. Whereas, on the 22nd day of September, in the year of our Lord, 1862, a proclamation was issued by the President of the United States, containing, among other things, the following, to wit, that on the first day of January, in the year of our Lord, 1863, all persons held as slaves within any state or designated part of state, the people whereof shall then be in rebellion against the United States, shall be then, thenceforward and forever, free. And the executive government of the United States, including the military and naval authority thereof, will recognize and maintain the freedom of such persons, and will do no act or acts to repress such persons, or any of them in any efforts they may make for their actual freedom. That the executive will, on the first day of January aforesaid, by proclamation, designate the states, or parts of states, if any, in which the people thereof respectively shall then be in rebellion against the United States. And the fact that any state or people thereof shall on that day be in good faith represented in the Congress of the United States by members chosen thereto at elections wherein a majority of the qualified voters of such states shall have participated, shall, in the absence of strong countervailing testimony, be deemed conclusive evidence that such state and the people there are not then in rebellion against the United States. Now, therefore, I, Abraham Lincoln, President of the United States, by virtue of the power vested in me as Commander-in-Chief of the Army and Navy of the United States, in time of actual armed rebellion against the authority of the government of the United States, and as a fit and necessary war measure for suppressing said rebellion, do on this first day of January in the year of our Lord 1863, and in accordance with my purpose so to do publicly, proclaim for the full period of 100 days from the day first above mentioned, order and designate as the states and parts of states wherein the people thereof respectively are this day in rebellion against the United States, the following, to wit, Arkansas, Texas, Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, and Virginia. And by virtue of the power and for the purpose aforesaid, I do order and declare that all persons held as slaves within said designated states and parts of states are henceforward and shall be free, and that the executive government of the United States, including the military and naval authorities thereof, will recognize and maintain the freedom of said persons. And I hereby enjoin those people, so declared, to be free to abstain from all violence unless necessary in self-defense, and I recommend to them that in all cases when allowed, they labor faithfully for reasonable wages. And I further declare and make known that such persons of suitable condition will be received into the armed service of the United States to garrison forts, positions, stations, and other places, and to man vessels of all sorts in said service. And upon this act, sincerely believed to be an act of justice, warranted by the Constitution, upon military necessity, I invoke the considerate judgment of mankind and the gracious favor of Almighty God. In witness thereof, I have unto set my hand and caused the seal of the United States to be affixed. Done that the city of Washington, this first day of January, in the year of our Lord, 1863, and of the independence of the United States of America, the 87th, by the President, Abraham Lincoln.
Yo!
5 weeks before June 19th in Florida, on May 10th, 1865, Brigham General Edward McCook and the Union Army arrive in Leon County to receive the surrender of Florida's Confederate troops. May 20th, 1865, Union General McCook reads the Emancipation Proclamation from the steps of the Knot House in Tallahassee. A celebration of freedom is held at Bull Pond, now called Lake Ella, in Tallahassee, Florida. Six years later, 1871.
Josiah, remember, they're strong. You come from kings and queens and warriors. And there ain't nothing you can't do. I love you, son.
I love you too, bro.
Raise your right hand. I. Say your name.
Josiah T. Wall.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I bear true faith and allegiance to same.
That I bear true faith and allegiance to same.
That I take this obligation freely.
That I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservation.
Or purpose of evasion.
Or purpose of evasion.
That I will well and faithfully.
That I will well and faithfully.
Discharge the duties of office.
Discharge the duties of office.
On which I am about to enter.
On which I am about to enter.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Congressman.
Say you.
And then when Zion comes on, lights. Go Zion.
Self-evident that all men are created equal. Yeah. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood? I have a dream.